Today we're opening one of the most insane Yu-Gi-Oh! Collections that I've ever bought. What's up, guys? We're back with an insane collection opening video. But before we do that, we do have a quick giveaway. I'll be giving away this Structured Deck Spirit Charmers. All you have to do is like the video, be subscribed, turn on notifications. Let me know your favorite card from this collection. Let's hop right into it. We are going to start this collection off with some absolute gas. We have a card that I have never actually owned before, so this is going to be interesting to show off. This is a card you may have heard of. The Masterpiece Series Platinum Blue Eyes White Dragon. So here's the packaging as well. So if you guys remember, this is the Blue Eyes White Dragon that cannot sold for $1,000 a piece. You had to like do like a pre-order thing and like get in line and all this stuff. I didn't even try to buy it at the time, but they went up to crazy prices. I'm not even sure the price right now. I think it might have come down a little bit, but it's still over $1,000 like they originally sold it for. So let's see what this thing looks like. Let's see what the packaging looks like, because we never did an unboxing of this because I never owned one. All right, let's open it up. Here we have the same thing. It's just written in black. Okay, nice. 2020. And we have... this thing is heavy, so it feels like... I don't know if like that's the card or if it's like some other like, you know, kind of plaque to stand it up or whatever. The authenticity, purity, 999 out of 1,000, approximately 22 grams. This is wild. This is wild. All right, let's see. Here it is. We have the Platinum Blue Eyes White Dragon. Very reflective. You can see me back there. Hello, guys. All right, cool. Check this out. Blue Eyes White Dragon. It is in the sealed. I think it's sealed. I guess you could get it out if you really wanted to. I don't think you probably should, but this is pretty wild. I mean, this thing is a hefty piece of, like, what is this? Platinum? I don't know. And then this big old thing, too. So it's a little bit scuffed back there, but very cool. This thing looks absolutely insane. So we have picked this up. I am buying this collection, but I am probably selling some of the cards, and this is probably one that will be for sale. So I don't know, maybe I'll hang on to it and keep it in the collection. I'm not sure yet if I'm really like super interested in it, because I was, you know, that's the reason I didn't buy it. I was like, I don't know if I really like want to buy this thing or not. So we just bought one anyway. So here it is. Honestly, a pretty insane item. So cool to at least see that on the channel at some point. Next up, we have a few deck boxes. We have a few cards inside. This is a pretty insane collection. I think these are more of like the bulky kind of cards. Let's see what they are. I mean, they're going to be foils, I think. So they're probably still going to be pretty nice. Called by the Grave. We got a couple of those. We got Wind the Wind Charmer. Not the Starlight. That's like $800 or something ridiculous like that. Spellbook of Judgment just got off the ban list. Hey, look, Substitute, there's one. Harvey's Featherstorm, we got the Super Quantum Red Layer. Yeah, so a bunch of decent stuff, you know. First Edition Dust Tornado, that's really nice. First Edition Nobleman, number 50. I mean, there's a lot of good cards in here. Solemn Judgments, lots of Solemn Judgments. Herald of the Orange Light's a very good card. Got a bunch of those. We got Blackwing Armed Wing. Has anyone noticed this? There's a weird space between Armed Wing. Is there supposed to be a dash there? Is that a misprint? Are they all like this? I'm actually really intrigued now. I don't know if that's the case. Let me know if you guys have an arm wing and it looks like that. Dimensional Barrier. Is that like a weird space or am I just losing it? Got a few of those. Raigekis. We've got Fusion Destiny. It goes in match. Just a bunch of nice staples. Reinforcement of the Army First Edition. Crystal Beast Ruby Carbuncle. Solemn Strikes. Solemn Strike. Thunder King Ryos for Edison. Very nice. Aroma Seraphy Jasmine and Fabled Raven. That's a secret rare. I didn't even realize that from D-Rev. Then we've got a nice Seven Tools of the Bandit. Nice card. Delinquent Duos. A lot of good stuff. Max C's. Those are, you know, coming off the ban list one day. Maybe. Who knows? Gate Guardian. That is a original print. Very cool. Genzo. Beast Skull. Thousand Eyes Restrict. Karibo. Sphere of Chaos. The Death Star. You got the Malanglacia. The Dark Voltanus. Voltanus the Adjudicator. Cyber Dragon Nova. Diamond Dire Wolf. Blood Shining Dragon, Gamma the Magnet Warrior, Beta the Magnet Warrior, Alpha, Valkyrion, Shieldwing, Mind Control, Knight's Title, Dark Magician Knight. I always think it's going to be like Dark Magical Knight, but Magician Knight, okay. Alistair, the Goat himself. I did sign one of these at Hartford, which was really fun. Not Hartford, well, where was I just at? Minneapolis. Hartford, I'm just used to talking about that. Dark Strike Fighter, pretty hard one to find. Actually, an insane card back in the day. A couple of those and Test Tigers. So yeah, this is like the bad stuff. So keep that in mind. Like that's insane. So you know, it's already good and it's supposed to be the bad stuff. So we have Instant Fusions, a bunch of Instant Fusions. Okay, Ojama Red himself. We got three of those. Metafall's Volflame. There's a bunch of random like play sets of stuff. We got the Sticky String Kaiju Doggeran for the Dino decks. Very nice. Gamma Seal. Interrupted Kaiju Slumber. Man, a Kaiju deck. Okay. Dark Magician Blue Eyes, Red Eyes. Harpy's Feather Dusters. Very nice. We've got the Trident Dragion. Ascended Sage. We've got the Morphtronic Remotin. Dino Wrestler Pankratop Secret. The best looking version, I think. Maybe the Collector Rare. It's pretty good. Link Karibo. We've got the Cat Shark Gold Secret. Morphtronic Cellophon with the real dual terminal, not the reprint one that came out. Dimensional Prisons. Actually, pretty nice for Edison's. We've got the Crystal Promise, which is Strike. Edgem Chain. I think that was money for a little bit because of Predaplant stuff. Then we've got the Mandragola, the Castor. We've got the Heat. Man, a lot of Evil Swarm stuff. This is like an Evil Swarm deck. Actually, cool how they're all in the same rarity, though. That's like super dope. Archfiends, Performal Pals, Cosmall Dark Lady, Cosmo Strawman, Tin Can, Farm Girl, and Dark Destroyer. That's like the big one, I think. Yeah, from Docs. That card was like $30 for a while. All right, the final deck box before we get into the binder. Yeah, we got a binder, and it's a nice one. So I haven't actually looked at it yet. Oh my gosh, these are like really stuffed in here. I think I might have just semi-bent this mirror wall. Did I? No, I don't think I did. Okay. Yeah, they were kind of stuffed in there, though. Definitely not enough room there. Machine Dupes. Oh, an ultimate rare. Unsleeved. Okay. The Makiro the Destructor. The original. The non-eroded print. Gagaga Cowboy. Very cool. Dragon Seeker Cobalt. Whoa, these are old rares. These are TP4s. Very nice. Beebuster Drake. Fallen of Albaz. Mikey on the Time Lord. Gearsu. Cosmojo. Grasslix Greener. Evil Swarm Ophion. We've got the title Dragon Ruler of Waterfalls. Very nice. Tempest Dragon Ruler of Storms. Redox Dragon Ruler of Boulders. All the Dragon Rulers. Evil Swarm Exiton Knight. Thanatos Nightmare. We've got Bahamut. So Evil Swarm stuff is everywhere in Blaster. So this is like an old school deck. Herald of the Arclight. So this is like, yeah, a deck from, you know, the Dragon Ruler times. Then we got a bunch of unsleeved stuff. So I guess this is like newer, I would guess. Some of it. Well, Limiter Removal. That's not new. Okay. Anti-Spell Fragrance. Cool. Dashers, man, those were money for a while. We've got the Stormwind Dragon, the Disc Commander, nice. Lina, we've got Linkaribo, we've got Rival of the Warlords. I mean, just a bunch of good stuff. Like, even the unsleeved stuff is pretty good here. Number 39s, Dark End Dragons, not SJC, unfortunately. Mizuki's cool. We've got Dimensional Fissures. Whoa, those are really good. Deep Sea Diva, also a good card. Red Eyes Black Dragons, Ghost Ogres, Kitchen Dragon Maid, Foolish Burial, Swap Frogs, House Dragon Maid, and that is it for those. But don't worry, we have the big stuff coming up in the binder. All right, we have the IP Mask Arena binder here with the alternate art, and inside is some pretty fire stuff right on the first page. We have LOB Dark Magician First Edition, Magic Formula First Edition from Glass, Dark Magician Girl First Edition from Magician's Force. We've got a UBP Exodia set. So this is a really rare Exodia set if you haven't heard of it. It was from a specific product where you get secret rare Exodia limbs and head. 10,000 dragon. I mean, that front page is insane. Like, that is a valuable first page right there. We'll check the conditions later. We have Injection Fairy Lily. I mean, it's going to be hard to keep up with that last one, but that was insane in terms of value. I mean, CED, first edition, 1,000 dragon, Blue Eyes Toon Dragon. That one appears to be in pretty bad shape. We've got Solemn Warning Ultimate Rare, Dark Arm Dragon Unlimited, but it's from Phantom Darkness, which is cool. Chaos Valkyrias, Collector Rares, that's beautiful. Cypher the Sky Dragon, we've got a Rescue Cat, that is a super rare. Soul Taker First Edition Glass, Archlord Zerato, Aeronite Parshath, Chaos Command Magician, Ancient Gear Golem First Edition, Luminous Soldier, Exodia Necros Unlimited. We've got ourselves Magician Black Chaos. If you guys saw the first episode of Guess That Price with Jarvis, you guys might remember this one. Go check it out if you guys haven't seen that series yet. There's a playlist. Tuning First Edition Ultis. That's really nice. Magicians Unite. That is from a Champion Pack. I don't remember which one. Champion Pack 3. Then we've got some Ultimate Rares. Oh, is that a Starlight? Oh, no. That's an Ultimate Rare 4 in it, seems. Or is it an Ultimate? Yeah. Ultimate. You can't really tell over here. They kind of look the same. Trigodia. Nice. From Turbo Pack 4. We got Cyber Laser Dragon. Winged Karibo, Transcendent Wings, and the, Winged Karibo level 10. That's a foreign copy. So if you guys see anything you're interested in, make sure to hit me up because most of it will be for sale. Some of it will be going to my collection, but feel free to ask. I can always just say no, and it's no big deal. Zen Maidy's cool. We've got Star Eater. That I think I actually need for my collection. That's dope. We've got Clearwing Synchro, Scrap Dragon. I might need a lot of this stuff. Red Dragon Arfine, Majestic Red Dragon, maybe? Red Nova Dragon. Wow, that guy's beat up. Check that out. We've got the Exploder Dragon Wing, the Majestic Star Dragon Ulti. Oh, the Catastor, very nice. Blackwing Dragon Ulti, I think I need that one too. Very cool. Odin Father Aesir, could need that, not really sure. And then a bunch of Watt Chimeras, okay. Okay, we got some cool stuff there. Arcanite, we pulled this the other day. What is it, Star Strike Blast Box? I think so. Then we've got the Demise King of Armageddon, the Divine Grace. I always thought that was a nice looking card. Horus up there, level 4. 3 Blue Eyes White Dragons. We got some Crystal Seers. All really nice Ultimate Rares. Beautiful. Overload Fusion is super dope. Even Unlimited. We've got the Ultimate Insects. Rose Warrior. Proto Cyber Dragon. Dandelion looks a little bit damaged, if I can tell. A Stardust Dragon. We've got a DD Crow, which is very beat up. A DD Crow, which is very beat up. We've got a... Is that a foreign shooting Star Dragon? I don't think I've ever seen that. Junk Berserker. That is not foreign. Okay, Malakota. I might need some of these as well. Oh, I think I do need an unlimited of that. I probably definitely need that card. And then Draco Knight. Hopefully they're near mint. We'll see. Levolve All Chains. We've got Minerva, the Exalted Light Sworns. Photon Bouncers. We've got Masterpiece, the True Draco Slayer. Gemini Summoner. Dark Freed. Very cool. Then we have Dark Magicians. Cool. The Dark Magician of Chaos. Dimension Fusion. This is the bad stuff. That's hilarious. We've got, ooh, Super Rare Pot of Greed. I love. Tiramisu's pretty valuable as well, I think. Veil of Darkness, Gaia, Vanity's Emptiness, Secret Rares, or at least some of them. Yeah, those are all Secret Rares. Hard to tell a little bit. You got three Super Polymerizations, a bunch of DD Crows, which I lost my first game ever to DD Crow in the Edison events at YCS Minneapolis. It was unfortunate. Twice the guy DD Crowed me in game three. Aplosa, Bow of the Goddess. We've got D Boys. We've got Max C's. We've got Karkar D. And then is that it? Wait, that might be it. One more page. Okay. Goyo Guardians Dual Terminal, which is super nice. We've got Ancient Fairy Dragon, Cyber Dragon Infinity, Chaos Goddess, and Power Tool. So, wow. A lot of amazing cards in here for sure. All right, let's check the condition of this 10,000 dragon. This thing looks awesome. Pull this out, which is always a little scary. Oh my gosh, this looks great. Got to make sure it's the real version. This does appear to be the real one. There are a bunch of fakes out there. So if you ever buy a 10,000 dragon, you got to be careful because there is a chance that it is fake, like a China version. And it's basically the text that'll give it away. It's like not the correct Konami text. This one appears to be right. I'm not seeing anything weird. So I think that we're good to go on that 10,000 dragon. Let's check out the Dark Magician from Legend of Blue Eyes. See what condition this bad boy's in. Is this wavy? I think it is wavy. It's kind of like weirdly not that wavy, but it feels wavy. I don't know if you know what I mean. The back appears to be a little bit scuffed up for sure. I thought he said this was like a PSA 8 or something. There's no way this was a PSA. I mean, maybe it was like in, you know, 2010 or something, but this would get like a 6 or a 7 now. Let's see this. So let's just do a little conditioning here. Off-centered, so that would take a grade away. A little bit of stuff on the surface on the front. We've got the back is pretty scuffed, like significantly. It looks like someone just took it and just like, you know, rubbed it on the thing a bunch. You know, it got some play. This honestly looks like a little dent here in the middle too. Wait, okay, I can't see it through the front, so it's just a little bit on the back. If it goes through the front, that's a lot worse, but I mean, that kind of scuffing is going to take, like, I mean, look at the top. There's some up there, too. You guys can see all of it. And it's not, like, pack scuffing. This is, like, playwear scuffing. Like, I don't know how you could, like, give this above a 6, you know, saying it's near mint. Because it's not, certainly not near mint. Because a 7 means near mint, which is always a little borderline. But I don't know about that one. I thought he said it was graded before. Maybe, I don't know. I'll have to figure that out later. Magic Formula. This one's supposedly near mint. We're going to find out, I guess. Let's see. We have Secret Rare. I've never actually held one of these first editions, so this is really, really cool. Centering is really nice on this card. Secret Rare looks good. This card's ridiculously expensive. Oh my goodness. Whoa. Okay. All right. We're going to have a discussion, I guess. Or at least I'm going to have to say I'm not going to be buying this like around near mint because, you know, some people have said like I like lie about conditions when I'm looking at like collections, not people who are selling me, but like in the comments I saw one, it was like, oh yeah, you become a harsh grader when you're opening collections. And I was like, what do you mean? Like I mean I'm not just gonna like this, like I'm not just gonna be like, okay, near mint, yep, looks near mint to me. Like I mean, you guys can see it there, that's clearly not near mint. I mean, you know, so it's like I just can't let you know, when you're buying stuff like for your collection or to even to just sell, like you can't just buy at a higher condition because like then you'll just start losing money, which doesn't make any sense. Okay, so that is unfortunate that is not quite the condition I was expecting, but let's see. We have, okay, a little bit of a ding up there on the top. A little bit of stuff going on. It's not as bad as the, you know, the magic formula, so that's good. This is, yeah, unfortunately, not great either. Okay, a little ding there as well. So, yeah, we're looking at, with this thing on the top where it's kind of, like, bent a little bit, and then this, and then the scuffing probably in the mod play. Okay, so some people have a plate and a mod play. I just go light plate to mod play. I don't know if they're, I don't even know which one plate should be. But that's just kind of what my mod play means. Some people might mean different by then. I just mean the one below light play for that. So, okay, not terrible. And then we'll check out the Exodia head. We're not going to check out all five pieces because they're probably pretty similar. So if they probably all came from the same place, we'll have to see. Let's see. We have Exodia the Forbidden One. Front looks pretty. The front on these does look good. I mean, the centering. Ooh, the centering is really bad on this. Look at that. Which centering does not take away from condition, by the way. A lot of people, you know, you can't call a card light played because it's off-center. You just say it's an off-center near mint card. So that would not be something that takes away. I just like to note that it's off-centered for you guys because you guys know I love centering. I actually don't care if a card's off-centered though, if I'm not great against. So it doesn't really bother me. Back actually looks super clean on this card. So this card actually looks really nice, which is a good sign. We will take that UBP Exodia, another one that I have never actually owned, so very, very cool. If you guys enjoy this collection video, make sure to let me know in the comments. Don't forget to let me know how much you think I should spend on this. You guys, you didn't get to see all the conditions, so just do your best to ballpark it. Usually, you guys are actually pretty good about, like, nailing how much I should pay, and I usually end up paying around what you guys have said. Some people are obviously way off saying too high or too low, but you guys are actually pretty solid at that, so I always like to see, like, where you guys are in terms of the value. Shout out to Toe Info Show, Daxter, Tomato Juice, JT Chode, TCG Trusted Cards, Puffins of Doom, Ernesto Deanda, Dizzy, Flexiboy, Hoppus, Choice 333, Miscycle, Melancholy, Ananas High Show, Christopher Ward, Ian Musa, John Nolan, Junior Barding, Mike Nance, Mimic Gecko, Stanley, and Thomas McLean. Thank you guys for supporting the channel, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.